So in this video, I'm going to address the risks and benefits of getting a corticosteroid injection around the tendon for tendinitis or tendinopathy. I'm going to solely focus on the risk that is associated with the exposure of the steroid to the tendon and not about the procedural risks such as bleeding, infection, injury to soft tissue structures, etc. Now let's focus on corticosteroids for tendon issues. So when we say tendon issues, so for those of you who don't know what a tendon is, basically these are the structures that connect the muscle to the bone. So there are a lot of tendons in our body. For example, like people can have like a tennis elbow, which is basically lateral epicondylitis. So this is the tendon, it's called the extensor tendon that commonly gets affected. So people can have golfer's elbow where a flexor tendon gets affected. People can have like a rotator cuff tendinopathy, which is basically the shoulder tendons that can cause tendinitis. So the common thought or the understanding like 10, 15 years ago was that the tendon pain is coming from tendinitis. So when you say tendinitis, basically means inflammation around the tendon. So we say that, okay, so there's inflammation. So let us say if you put a corticosteroid, which is an anti-inflammatory, the pain goes away. In reality, actually, it did make sense and it actually helped a lot of pain among these subjects. And it still holds true that the corticosteroids can provide short-term pain relief. But as we know more, we find that the tendinitis actually not just inflammation on the tendon. We have changed our paradigm thinking as more like tendinopathy. So what I mean by that is that, so now we think it's more like a degenerative process. So basically there's a lot of chronic non-inflammatory, so that's the key word here, non-inflammatory molecules that is trying to heal the tendon and they're basically not able to do so. So our focus should be on healing. The concern with the corticosteroids is that, as I said before, the corticosteroids, yes, they provide short-term pain relief, but they do affect tissue healing. So now the question is that, does a short-term pain relief, is that most important, or long-term healing is most important? Now let us think about this. So there was actually one study, right? So there was a study, it was back in like, I think it was 2002 or so. So they did a study on a tennis elbow. So basically they did a, there was a group that got a corticosteroid injection. There was a group that actually did not get any intervention. There was a group that got physical therapy intervention. So what they did, what they saw was that after the corticosteroid injection, people got better. Within 6 weeks, there's a good short-term pain relief after the steroid injection. Whereas for people with wait and see approach, there was not much of a benefit. But then At one year mark, they're looking at, okay, how many people are pain-free in the corticosteroid group? How many people are pain-free in the wait and see approach? And studies actually show that in the corticosteroid group, only 67 people are pain-free, whereas in wait and see approach, there was almost 83% pain-free. And the people with the physical therapy group actually was like 90 plus percent was pain-free. So that brings us to the point where, yes, the steroids might provide a short-term pain relief, but long-term, are we making a benefit? But It's not as easy to make a decision like that, because sometimes there are some instances why I end up giving an injection after discussing the short-term and the long-term relief. For example, like, so it could be an athlete who might have had a lifetime opportunity to participate in an event, and because of the pain, he's limited. And in that scenario, we talk about the short-term risk and still give the injection. Or say, let's say a workman is going to lose his job if he doesn't do the work, and in that case, an injection might be helpful, knowing that there is always a risk for long-term healing.
Obviously, there are certain tendons that I would never expose them to steroid, such as patellar tendon, posterior tibialis tendon, Achilles tendon, to name a few, as they may pose a high risk for tendon rupture. So make sure you see the right doctor who actually has a good knowledge about tendons and bones before you consider the steroid injection. I hope this video is helpful. If you have any questions, please post in the comments below, and I'll see you in my next video. Until then, goodbye.